EA Sports.
There are no coaches. There are no stadiums. Play where we want, how we want. This is style over strategy.
No timeouts, no sidelines. Out here, we play both sides of the ball. This is Flash over Fundamentals.
We play by our rules. So get ready, because this is who we really are. This is our game.
Cool.
I guess the big question is, like, in the last couple of years, you've seen so many people break songs, actually, in video games and put out music specifically for video games. What made you guys do it for Streetball?
Well, NFL Street is a game coming out. EA's releasing it this winter. And the staff there were fans of us. They already knew the group. And while in the beginning stages of creating the game, some of the guys suggested that they hook up with us to do the music. And I think the cool thing about the game, it's a street football game, but the music is going to be interactive with the game. So it's not like just an intro with a rap song or a rock song. While you play the game, you're going to hear scratches and things are going to occur in the music that reflects what happens in the game. So if there's a touchdown, you're going to hear certain scratches come out. If there's an interception, maybe there's like a backward scratch or a reverse scratch. And we did all the production and basically we were the overseers of the music. So that's the cool and special thing about the game. So it's going to be real cool.
Did you ever think, though, when you guys first started making records, you know, video games was going to be one way for you guys to break your music?
I mean, when we first started making records, we were just thinking, like, you know, just to embrace the crowd for, like, what we do as far as DJing and then take it to a level of performing the album, you know. But we never really thought of us just having, you know, opportunities like EA gave us to score music for a game called NFL Street. You know what I mean? Like, that's definitely something that's, you know, on a whole another level for us, you know? And, and these guys are real cool, and, like, they're pretty much down for the crown as far as, like, you know, hip-hop. And
I think one of the cool things is that hip-hop and video games are starting to really make a strong connection. One of the earlier Madden games, Ludacris was on one of the songs rapping, and I didn't know who Ludacris was. I remember I turned the game on, hear his voice, and not know who he was. And then after he came out and became a success, I remember seeing an interview with him, and he was like, yeah, you know, one of my first things was like a video game I rapped on, Madden. And I was like, that was Ludacris, you know. So I think the video games are a good forum for especially groups like us that may not really be well-known in small towns, let's say somewhere in Nebraska where someone doesn't know who the Executioners are or never seen us perform, but knows a video game, goes out and buys a video game and may hear our scratches, and through that video game they're being exposed to our music, you know, so it's a real cool connection, definitely.
EA Sports.
Welcome to the SSX World Championships, where it's you against the mountain. This is EA Radio Big, coming to you from high above it all. I'm DJ Atomica, the eyes and ears of SSX for spectators and competitors alike. Broadcasting live from my nifty little sound booth with access to over 262 mountain cams. At the competitors' committee request, this year's events will be happening on one ginormous mountain across three wicked peaks. Peak 1 may appear to be nice and inviting, but riders need beware. For one thing, the steepness limit in the backcountry's been increased from 36 to 44 degrees of insanity, not to mention the avalanche warnings. Peak 2 can get pretty challenging. Weather can be a serious factor as storms often batter the peak senseless. Blizzards, 70-mile-per-hour winds, you name it. Riders will have to be on top of their game to beat this peak. And when it comes to Peak 3, you gotta love it when they save the harshest for last. A mountain dream that turns into an alpine nightmare. This is where we give Everest a serious run for its money. It's taken event organizers 2 years to turn this place into the ultimate SSX championship. Riders will be charging hard down these newly designed, never-before-seen racetracks where the terrain borders on the insane. New events like Slopestyle will be pitting riders against a host of constructs. Competitors will be looking to snake the best lines through the wildest tracks to perform legendary tricks. And for that little bit of extra value, there's gonna be a whole lot of combo linking for those looking to score big. Abilities will be maxed right off the start with the circuit's new big air events. Riders will be going harder and higher than anything seen before. This year's Super Pipe events promise to be the most outrageous pipe action ever seen. In the early days of pre-competition training, competitors are unleashing a barrage of never-before-seen moves. One event official summed it up best: absolutely sick. These guys are pushing the limits here, people. And yet another new twist on this year's event, big challenges. Riders will find themselves put to the test in some absolutely bizarre ways. Event organizers have been deliberate in telling SSX riders to be careful out there, and in particular, to stay clear of the out-of-bounds areas. New to this year's circuit is the uber-talented Allegra Sauvages. Mountain man Nate Logan, style meister Vigo Rolig, and boy wonder, Griff Simmons. In addition, a few of the SSX veterans have returned: Amazon bombshell Elise Riggs, hip-hop scenester Mac Fraser, and crowd favorite Zoe Payne, to name a few. There you have it, folks. The stage is now set for the biggest SSX event of all time.
Start again. Try not to break the game.
I want to put you on one that's a little easier for tricks then, if you want to do the tricks. Is that it?
Sure, whatever. Yeah, whatever's easier for tricks.
Which one? Yeah, Snow Jam's probably pretty easy for tricks. Our competitor's spotlight targets the small and he's grinning in English and booty.
Yeah, I've noticed that about him.
Sullen. Ow.
Dun-dun-dun.
Did they say dreadlocked funk?
Nice.
Perfect landing.
Front flip, good landing. Very, very, very exciting. Oh, look, he's getting fancy.
Wow, I got $3 for doing that move.
Whoa, what are you going to buy first?
Now.
Oh, there's no money for
new face, how about that?
All right, go up, do a big trick. Something cool, spin, capped off the trees, and it lands on your head.
My face.
Yeah, that.
Oh, and then, ow. Oh, dude, that sucks, dude.
Hold on. Here we go. Ow! Aw. Oh. There, dude.
Alright. Yeah, right.
Much better. Very classy.
Oh, ah, see, I knew I was going to run into that. Where the hell did that
see, now he's not
from?
Getting up from that in real life.
See, that's the most fun of these games is you can attempt tricks you would never try in real life because you know you'll get up.
Ow.
to the world of the virtual athlete, where it's man against man, but somebody must get beat. You gotta be man enough to bring that heat, and if you ain't ready to ball, then you should take that seat. From the rooftops of New York to West Palm Beach, you gotta be a fanatic or a b-ball freak. AI crosses you so fast, you thought you was asleep. With the speed of Supernatural when he's spitting on beats, with the precision of Kobe when he's draining from deep. These are true platinum players with games that sweep. This is NBA ballers when it's on, then it's on. When the players invite you into their mansions and homes, and I'm Supernatural, you can ball with me. So let's ball and see who can be the MVP.
To go, can Rick Craven make it happen?
Go, go, go!
Getting physical here at Darlington Raceway like it's supposed to be.
Ricky Craven, Kurt Busch, side by side, they both. Busch crosses the wall. Ricky Craven has won the race.
NASCAR Thunder 2004.
EA Games.
Johnny Gomez.
And I'm Nick Diamond.
And we've got two groups of overpaid pretty boys with a beef that's been festering for months.
Let me warm up on your sorry ass.
Get ready to die.
Bad girls rule.
As usual, the crowd is wired for excitement.
Let me put my insanity to work.
Smell something I do. Cool. This would have made a great video.
Think this is unprecedented.
The moment you've been waiting for.
EA Games.
In a world filled with menace, where nothing is as it seems, there's always one man, one name you can count on. fall. James Bond, 007. Everything or nothing.
EA Games.
Challenge everything.
The battle for Helm's Deep is over. The battle for Middle Earth is about to begin.
It took two in the nose, then dropped into the atmosphere.
Who was first contact?
405th out of Diego Garcia. But don't expect a big welcome. Coming and wipe most of them out before they hit the ground.
Immediate. Grid Kilo 2-3 is hot. Recommend mission abort.
Roger.
Your call, Sarge.
We're going in. Get tactical, Marines!
Covenant ground forces own this city. We'll need to deal with them before we can kill that cruiser.
CP's this way.
Must be seen. That's the last dude of this year.
Come on, come on, come on. Stay with me, Marine.
No tags.
Hang two units, O'Ne, and he needs an airway.
I'm calling it. It's 1900. The lieutenant got hit as soon as we dropped in.
Who's in charge now, Corporal?
Sergeant Banks, ma'am. He's pinned down up front. Come on, I'll show you.
Behind that ST.
Yeah.
Three more coming left.
I'm running low, man.
Oye, Parsons.
Yeah?
Is it clear?
You tell me.
Coño.
Friend is moving out. Covering fire.
For reinforcements. I didn't think they'd send a Spartan.
out. Cover me! Tech HQ, this is Sergeant Banks.
Bingo. There's the cruiser. Now, all we need to do is... Bet you can't stick it.
You're on.
Like King Kong, and just like ping pong, back and forth, I feel Molotovs. It's time to floss my verbal affirmation is to always go off. When syllables slide, you'll be enjoying the vibe. We consider it pride
and J-Box.
With another deadly, deadly camera action, yo, we heavy, aim steady, slash machete, Maserati, engine ready, with a plenty, don't be petty, confetti, and we jet on to another city, where we do our nitty gritty. We wild like Serengeti, Terra down like Stephen Zeddy. Get ready for the ride, verbally hang glide, right and stay tied. Missions inside, murderer worldwide, the stage is show.
That first line's the same, though. Okay. Hey, you skate pretty well. Let's see if you can hang with me. Do you want me to just keep reading it over and over? Okay. All right. Hey, you skate pretty well. Let's see if you can hang with me. Hey, you skate pretty well. Let's see if you can hang with me. Is that it? That's it. You want to go to the next one? Okay. All right. Russia. Cool, eh, comrade? The locals are eating up this trick I've been working on up here. Russia. Cool, eh, comrade? The locals are eating up this trick I've been working on up here. Russia. Isn't that cool? Yeah, the locals are eating up this trick I've been working on up here. Yeah? Yeah. Right. Right. Okay. Okay. All right. Russia. Cool, eh, comrade? The locals are eating up this trick I've been working on up here. Russia. Cool, eh, comrade? The locals are eating up this trick I've been working on up here. Is that good? This is real. He'll flip lane. Okay. I'll tell you what. You give it a try. Land tricks until you get your special meter full. Special meter. Okay. I'll tell you what. You give it a try. Land tricks until you get your special meter full, and then do a 360 varial heel flip lean. I'll tell you what. You give it a try. Land tricks till you get your special meter full, then do a 360 varial heel flip lean. That it? That's it. Oh, Allie.
Wrecking Gideon, dude.
I know. Gideon deserves it for not being here. Oh, there's that knee buckle that I hate. So that's usually my style. I just do combos. I get a lot of points and I fall, and then I don't get credit for any of the stuff that I just did. That's why I run it. But I'm more of a half-pipe skater.
At what point does someone say, you know, you should be able to grind a pipeline?
Why shouldn't you be able to? You know, they're rails in their own right, and if we're going to put them in there, they might as well be. It's basically anything we put in the game is going to be skatable in some form.
One of the things that always impressed me about the Tony Hawk games is music choices. Are you pretty involved in those?
I make suggestions of things, but inevitably it's a really complicated process, and we just try to keep it really diverse. And you know, some well-known acts, but also some up-and-coming ones.
Well, I've noticed there's been some classic bands.
Right. So. You know, just try to keep a healthy mix, and there's a lot of bands that just like the game so much they want to be in it however they can, and some bands see it as their sort of breakout chance.
Yeah, you know, that's something that I was talking to somebody about the other day, is how video games are almost like another form of like a way to release a single. It's like radio, game song.
Yeah, and so there is that value in it too, you know, so... It just depends, but we just, like I said, try to keep a really eclectic mix. Oh. What's that? What was that?
shoulders together.
Oh. I'm not good at cavemanning yet. I gotta work on that.
When you're running around, you can jump on a rail and try and do it. What are your favorite things you're able to do?
That's a good one. What's that?
What are your favorite things you're able to do in this one that you...
Well, I'm more of a vert skater, so I like the vert tricks. You know, like going on the quarter pipes. Where are the quarter pipes in this level? Like this stuff. And I like the revert function.
Something like Michelle's video, you think, if only I could have my song be a soundtrack to something that's that entertaining.
For me to give them a good video is to go in a place I've never been before.
He was a taskmaster, an egomaniac. He was firing guns off. Nah, he was brilliant.
Was almost like a weird ritual.
Turkey, gravy, mashed potatoes, of course, and cranberry sauce, which is easy. I mean, just open the can.
Oh, sweetie.
I like it from the can.
Nobody likes it from the can.
It's just completely selfish of her, asking us to come all the way to New York.
Some families do whatever it takes to remain close.
They're probably not even gonna come.
Okay, everybody, let's move it!
And then there are families who know better.
We're gonna have a very nice time.
You don't actually believe that.
It's possible, I think, yes.
No! No! Does anybody have a stove by tomorrow?
Try Wayne in 5D. He's got a new stove.
Are you Wayne? Wayne with a new stove. What makes her think she can cook all of a sudden? I don't remember her ever being in the kitchen.
She's met this new guy.
Bobby!
Apparently, this guy Bobby reminds her of me.
This is a nice thing you're doing.
You must have a special relationship.
We're very close.
For days, I've been trying to think of nice April memories, and I can only come up with one.
She was just gazing out the window, and she said, "Oh, Mother, don't you just love every day?"
That was me.
What about the crayon drawing she did of the Mayflower, the one you had framed?
That was me, too.
Oh, cut it out.
You don't get along, do you?
Not at all. Never have.
Just off the top of my head, I have one. She was sleeping. She was wearing a pink nightgown.
That was me. Kidding.
You've never been in love. Yeah, well, it does things to you.
Once there was one day when everybody seemed to know they needed each other.
Pieces of April.
Welcome to Krispy Kreme. May I take your order?
Just remember, everybody, April is cooking.
We'll need an extra dozen glaze.
Yellow hat. Really, 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 like, you know, the yellow hat.
No foreseeable problems. I was about to check your turkey myself, but then I thought, since it's yours, maybe you'd prefer to do the checking. Certainly don't mind. So much can go wrong. Turkey can dry out in places, be overcooked, undercooked, which is a health hazard. What about basting?
You know what, Wayne, I'll be up in a sec.
Seconds up.
See you in a minute.
It was going to be that easy, did you?
You know, for a second there, yeah, I kind of did.
Detective David Starsky did everything by the book.
I said freeze!
Detective Ken Hutchinson never even read it.
You're late. I've been here since 8.
8 o'clock?
I didn't know this place opened today.
But now, they'll face their biggest problem yet.
You two deserve each other. You're partners.
Whoa!
You coming?
I like your style.
I like your moves.
She's like, which one do you like? Because we're going to stick to this.
Well, I've always had a thing for blondes.
Because I'll take anything.
Got some questions for you.
Look, I like you guys, okay? Especially you.
Let me see your belly button.
No. Just show them a little skin. Nobody's here.
Oh, Eureka.
God, that's nice.
This grass is Alabama creeping bean.
You know a lot about golf.
I know even more about grass.
Hang on,
Starsky.
No! Hang on!
Starsky and Hutch.
All right, now Starsky and Hutch. Who's cooler, Starsky or Hutch?
Who's cooler? Probably Ben's not around, but I don't think he'd care even if he was around. Probably my character's a little bit cooler. His character is a little bit kind of aggro and a little stressed out. And then through the course of the movie, he kind of... begins with a sort of like a halfway point that we meet at, and he kind of gets a little bit more, develops a little more finesse, which is what I like to think my character has.
Who's smarter, Starsky or Hutch?
Again, I'd have to probably say Hutch is smarter, and I don't know why, that's just my off-the-cuff answer.
Who's got more sex appeal, Starsky or Hutch?
Well, in the movie, I don't want to make this like it's like, you know, Hutch is everything, but I don't know. Actually, Ben like gets out on the dance floor in this movie and like busts some like kind of John Travolta moves. So girls usually respond to guys that are good dancers. So maybe Ben, but then later in the night, the two girls that were with Carmen Electra and Amy Smart, I end up kind of hooking up with. So I don't know.
Wow, you're clearing. It's a sweep. It's a Hutch sweep. It's a Hutch sweep. All right, now you got this automobile here.
Yeah, now this is Starsky's domain. This is the Gran Torino, and it's our undercover car. And it's kind of odd that such a kind of noticeable car would be used by detectives to do undercover work, but that's the premise. And Ben won't let me drive this car, or his character won't let me drive it, so I never get to drive it.
Hey, have you driven it yet?
No, I haven't, because Ben won't let me drive it.
He's so method.
Yeah. Thank you.
American soldier serves more than his army. He's a selfless defender of our rights and freedoms. He is proof that one soldier can and does make a difference. Sergeant CJ Overway, an Army of One.
Log on to GoArmy.com.
I am a soldier. An army of one. Even though I am part of the strongest army in the world, I am my own force. With the latest technology, training, and support, who I am has become better than who I was. And I'll be the first to tell you, the might of the U.S. Army doesn't lie in numbers. It lies in soldiers like me. Specialist Mark DeCarli. I am an army of one. And you can see my strength.